Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I'm coming to your home to pray with you. And I thank God for your life. This is Reverend Dr. Christine Nsiki. Welcome you. Welcome you to Prayerline. And thank you so much to listening to me in Jesus' name. And our God is a good God. He loves you. And I too, I love you. It is a good time that I come to share with you this word of God. The word of God that I want to share with you, the title is Conducing the Enemy of Your Calling. God has called you. You are a special child. God has given you everything. Your father loves you. My father loves me. Our father, God, loves us. He doesn't want us to live this life that we are. He wants you to be happy and enjoy the life he has given to you. Our God is the owner of silver and gold. Our God is the creator of everything you see in this world. Our God, he wants us, remember, because of his love, because he loves us so much, because he loves you. He loves you so much. And he has given you everything. But the enemy, who is the devil, Lucifer, Satan, the whole serpent called the devil, is after you and taking everything from you. Therefore, you will send conviction into his camp. You are going to send conviction to your enemies. The enemy of your calling, the enemy that it does not want you to have anything, this is what you are going to do. You will send conviction to the camp. And they will be confused that they will never think of touching you anymore. If any power that is touching you after this prayer, and still you are suffering, call me. I will change them and break them into pieces. God has given me power. Even you yourself, God has given you power against the works of the enemy. The Bible says in Luke 10 verse 19, I have given you power to trumpet and on serpents and scorpion. Nothing shall hurt you by all means. Therefore, as Jesus himself give you power, give me power, the same power that he has given you and me, this is the power I'm going to use to send conviction into the camp of the enemies. Let's look in the book of Jeremiah, Jeremiah 20 verse 11. The book of Jeremiah, the book of Jeremiah chapter 20 verse 11, the Bible says, listen very carefully, child of God. What does the Bible say? The Bible says, but the Lord is with me as a mighty, terrible one. Therefore, my persecutors shall stumble and they shall not prevail. They shall be greatly ashamed, for they shall not prosper. Their everlasting conviction shall never be forgotten. You see? The Bible says, but the Lord is with me as a mighty terror one. The Lord is with you. The Lord is with me like a terror, like a mighty terror one. Therefore, my persecutors shall stumble and they shall not prevail. Your persecutors will stumble and they will not prevail. Your persecutors, the enemy that is fighting you, will not prevail, will stumble. They will stumble. They will fall down and die. They will be confused. They will not stand in the name of Jesus. The Bible is clear. And the Bible says, and they shall not prevail. They shall be greatly ashamed. Your enemy are going to be greatly ashamed because they plan evil. Now God is going to turn the evil they plan to you, and it will turn to good. So the enemy, your enemy, will be disgraced and ashamed because they've been planning evil against you. Therefore, let every evil the enemy is planning against you to go back to their camp. Let confusion fall upon them in Jesus' name. For they shall not prosper. Their everlasting confusion shall never be forgotten. They will not prosper. Don't let the witch, don't let the enemy prosper in your life, because the Bible has said they will not prosper. Therefore, any enemy in your life shall not prosper in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I take authority against the works of the enemy that wants to prosper in your life. I command them to get out and out in Jesus' name. The enemy will not prosper in your life forever, in the name of Jesus. The enemy will not prosper. The enemy will not prosper forever. This is what the word of says. Jeremiah 20, chapter 20, verse 11. The enemy will not prosper. They will confused. They are going to be confused forever, in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. My God, I thank you. Jesus Christ, I give you the glory, in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Let all the powers encumbering against my goodness and breakthroughs become confused, be shattered in the name of Jesus. Remember the book, what the Bible says. The Bible is talking to individual. The Bible is talking, but the Lord is with me. So the Bible is talking individual. It's talking, the Lord is with me. So you claim this scripture. You say, the Lord is with me. When I pray this prayer, you say amen. That is individual prayer. So you say amen, and my children, amen. In the name of Jesus Christ, let all the powers of my adversaries, let the powers of my adversaries be rendered, imported in the name of Jesus. Let every evil tongue uttering curses and other evil pronouncements against my life be completely silenced in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, my Father. In the name of Jesus, Lord, I thank you. Jesus, I glorify your name. Jesus Christ, your Lord. I command every stronghold and the powers holding my nights, my lights and goodness to be violently overthrown in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ, I command every power of the enemy working against me, I command them to be confused and render powerless in Jesus' name. I confuse the camp of the enemies. Let my enemies make mistakes that will promote me in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ, I command every enemies of my soul, every enemies of my calling, every enemies that is working against my life, according to the word of Jeremiah 20, verse 11, the Bible says they will not prosper. They will not prosper forever. Therefore, any witch, any enemy that is prospering in my life, I set fire into their life and let them burn to ashes in Jesus' name. I command enemies, according to the word of God, that they will not prosper in my life. The Bible says, when the enemy comes like floods, the Lord will raise up a standard of the Holy Spirit to fight him. Therefore, I am taking the authority against enemy that is prospering in my life. Enemy that you are prospering my life to block me, I will not do anything. I've never achieved anything. You are a liar. Today, Jeremiah is telling you, according to the word of Jeremiah, that you will not prosper in my life forever. Therefore, I command you to get out of my life, to get out of the life of this person, to get the life of this woman, to get the life of this man in Jesus' name. You are a liar, devil. You are a liar. Get out of this person forever. Get out of this life of these people in the name of Jesus Christ. my Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I take the authority against the works of the enemy, against the powers and rulers of darkness, against every power that wants to convince me. I reverse this conviction and I return back to you in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, in the Holy Spirit, teach us to avoid unfriendly foods and unprofitable to decisions. Father, in the name of Jesus, you are a God of all, you are a God who does not change. You are God, our Father. You love us, all of us. You love us and you have asked us that wherever believe in you shall not perish. Wherever call upon your name shall be saved. Because your word is very true and it will never fail. The enemy does not call upon you. The enemy is calling their gods to embark them. Lord, as I call you as my living, my Father, to pack up my prayers, to pack up the prayers of these people. Father, in the name of Jesus, you are our Father. As we come before this time, as we come and give you the honor, the glory, we thank you and magnify your name. You are a wondrous God. We love you, Jesus. We honor you. We acknowledge your name. Thank you, Father, for you alone, you are God. No one is like you. You are everything to us. We acknowledge your name. Thank you for your word this morning. In the name of Jesus Christ, my Father, my Lord, I lift up your name, Jesus, and I give you all the glory. Our Father, we thank you. We acknowledge your name. In the name of Jesus Christ, hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Oh, Lord, let your fire destroy every foundation problem in our life, in the life of this person, in my life. Anything, any evil foundation, any wicked powers of the enemy, let it be destroyed. Let the fire of God burn them to ashes in Jesus' name. Let every link, label, and oppression be destroyed by the blood of Jesus. By the power in the blood of Jesus, I am taking the authority right now in Jesus' name. Father God, I pray for this person. I pray for these children. I pray for everyone who listened to me with this prayer in the name of Jesus, and I ask the fire of God to consume every work that is working against them. Every enemy of your soul, I command the fire of God to consume them. Let the Holy Ghost, the fire, confuse the camp of the enemy. Let power change hand, enter into the hand of the enemy, and let them be destroyed in the name of Jesus. My Father, my Lord, I bind every strong man in your father's house. I bind every strong man in your mother's house. I bind the powers that says no to your breakthroughs. I bind the powers that are eating your prosperities. I bind them and I render them powerless in the name of Jesus. You will not stand. The Bible says you will stumble and fall down and die in the name of Jesus. You will not prevail in Jesus' name. Anything you are doing to our life, anything you are doing to the life of this person, anything you are doing to the life of the individuals, you will not prosper in Jesus' name. I thank you, Lord. I give you the glory. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. Thank you very much. God bless you. We'll continue with the prayers. Join me the prayer line, and also join me in Ustream. Join me in Facebook. Join me in Twitter. Write the description and recommend the videos. If you are blessed to these prayers, please you can donate to us. I accept the cash. I accept the money order. I accept the MoneyGram, Western Union. All. If you don't know what to do, call me. I will help you to show you how you can send your donation. God bless you so much and have a good day. Thank you so much and have a good day. Bye-bye.